guys, it's Ayushi and welcome back to my channel. So I was not at all planning to do a DIY video because you guys know we are moving to a new house. We've started packing and doing everything, and in the middle of that I'm taking intro and I somehow managed to film a DIY video. I did that because this is going to be my last DIY video in this house, and yeah, I was very excited. Plus I wanted to, you know, use my background and everything, the lighting and everything before I leave this place. So yeah, very excited to share a DIY video with you guys. And I think by the time you guys are watching this video, we would be in our new house. So this DIY video is just me painting random things. You guys are like really pro when it comes to painting. Yeah, please don't judge. So not that great, but I just love how all of them have turned out. Before I start with this video, please guys make sure to subscribe my channel. Please subscribe, give this video a big thumbs up, and without wasting time, let's get started with the video. So I was really excited to paint, even though I'm not that good, but yeah, I just decided to paint few random items I had, so hope you enjoy. First object that I have is this small wooden hairbrush. I went with this beautiful sky blue color, which is my favorite, and painted only the backside of the brush. I let it dry for a few hours. I just wanted to keep it simple. Plus, I was really worried to ruin it. So I went with a very basic design, made tiny flowers all over the brush with a pencil. Then using pastel yellow acrylic paint, I'll color the center of the flower. Then made white petals using white acrylic paint. It was fun coloring it, and I don't trust my painting skills. That is why I went with this simple design, and I feel it looks very pretty. You can add varnish or a decor glue if you want, and that's it. I was scared to paint this, but I'm very happy with the way it looks. It looks way beautiful in person, guys, and yeah, really excited to use it. Next, I had this old specs case, chashma ka dabba, that nobody uses in my house, and yeah, thought of painting it. So the cover is very dark, and I decided to go with a base color first. So I'll color it using white acrylic color. Yeah, that's Akshita painting the rest. I was busy eating vada pav. So she was helping me with the base, this is how we finished coloring everything, and I'll let it dry. For colors, I went with these beautiful pastel colors. Now when it comes to DIY, I can still experiment, but when it comes to painting, I'm always nervous. So I had no particular design in my mind. For the design, I'll keep it simple. Anybody can do it. I think this will look really good even on notebook covers or phone cases. It looks really fun coloring it, but I was so nervous. Yeah, look at the concentration level. Like, you can see my head here. I'm so into it. I wanted the lines and edges to be perfect, and yeah, it looks really good. So I had to let it dry before I start coloring the other side of the case. I painted it plain orange color and that's it. Love the colors. It turned out really beautiful. I had no idea how it will look in the end, but I'm so happy with the result. And yeah. Some of you might remember this pouch. I showed it in a craft haul video long back, and since then I really wanted to paint it. It's a jute material, so I knew it's going to be a little hard to paint or draw on it. For design, I went with this very basic mandala design. It was hard to draw, so somehow I managed and then started painting each section with different colors. So I was literally out of acrylic colors. I really need to go and buy acrylic colors. Maybe I'll do a craft or DIY supplies haul very soon, because I am planning to buy some supplies. So yeah, stay tuned for that. So I had to apply 2 coats to make it look more colorful. So I had to do something with the design because I felt it looked very simple. So I decided to add these stones using fabric glue. I'll put my colorful pens in it and really excited to use it. Then I bought this round piece of board from a craft store and I wanted to paint it, for which you'll need a paper cup or any container. You can use more paper cups for color mixing. I always keep such empty or dried acrylic bottles to reuse them in my other DIY projects. So here I'll do the same. And you'll need liquid dishwash. So first step is to mix equal proportion of dishwash and water. Mix it well. Now I'll take both the bottles or cups, whatever you're going to use, and add acrylic color in each bottle. So I'm going with white and black. Then pour little dishwash mixture with each color. You'll get such runny and very thin consistency. Add more mixture if the color is thick to make it thin. Now I'll take the round board and start pouring each color one by one on top of it. I have showed something similar to this, but it was a flip cup technique. This is like a little more easy. I know some people find this waste of colors and some people don't like doing it, but it's a way of painting, guys. It's a technique and it's really fun. It's up to you. You can reuse this waste paint and color something else with it. Plus, the outcome is very beautiful. So here I'm just moving the colors around so that it blends and create a marble effect. You can go for multiple colors or you can go for just 2-3 shades. Add more colors on it and keep moving to get a beautiful pattern. Absolutely love it. Looks very beautiful. I'm planning to put resin on top of it and use it as a coaster. If I do it, I'll definitely share a video on that. And yeah, love it. So that's it for this video, guys. Let me know which was your favorite. I'm not really pro at painting, but I definitely tried and I had fun. Hope you guys enjoyed it too. And guys, this is our last DIY video in this house. Hope you guys enjoyed it. I'm gonna miss this background. Really excited for the new beginning and everything. Stay tuned for all the videos. Yeah, I'll see you guys very soon with another fun video. Bye bye, keep inspiring.